Knut, what are you doing in here?
Eivor, we need your help.
Who's we?
Sylvie and Ira are in trouble. We went into the woods and there's no time to explain. You need to come with me.
Are they all right?
No, they're hurt and badly.
Take me to them. Where are they?
Not far. We need to hurry.
What happened? Are they still in danger?
Not if we get there soon.
Which way now?
This way. We're almost there. Come on, Eivor. Can't you run any quicker?
Knut, you have to tell me what has happened.
I can't. You won't understand. Even if I do, just trust me.
What is this about?
Sorry, Eivor. We had to trick you. But it wasn't my idea. It was Ira's.
Lying is not a good way to get my attention, children.
But we found a dog that needs your help. She's caught in a trap down there. We thought you wouldn't come if you knew it was just a dog.
Oh. That is not the sound of a dog, Ira. That is a wolf.
But a wolf is a kind of dog, yes? My mother told me that.
Of course it's a kind of a dog. Listen to that sound. Awoo! Pure dog. Eivor, if you won't help us free her, we must do it ourselves.
There's no need. Let me see what I can do.
We must help her. She could be starving.
For her. She's crying. We have to help.
Her family probably misses her.
This house needs a key. If I'm lucky, there's one nearby. The children must have missed you, poor fellow. Or they might be singing a different song. It looks like something attacked you. An animal. A key here. I should look around. Wallace isn't here to butcher you. But I need to see if you're carrying a key. And there it is. Along with your last meal. I'll free that wolf. And pray to Tyr that I needn't slay it in front of the children. The table is set. He never made it home. At least his end came quickly.
There's no safety in alliances with savages and dank outsiders. Despite my warnings, they invite Viking strangers into our village and mingle with the degenerates. Damn them all. I say if they will open their gates to those people, then they are shut to me. I am happier to live alone in safety than in the chaos they have been. Well, you know what? That's what I think. That's what I think.
These skulls bear teeth marks. The wolf must have helped him take them down. liked his trophies. At least he leaves that legacy. Easy. You have a kind look to you, I think.
The pup hanging about and begging for scraps is a decent hunting dog. I have slain more wolves in my time than I care to count, but this one seems to have been away from her pack long enough that she has lost her wilder and crueler instincts. She proves herself useful. I may even give her a name.
Wait, easy now!
Deceived by children and shouting at wolves. I was a warrior once.
Are you all right? Did you see the wolf?
Yes, you freed her. You're amazing, Eivor.
But she ran away and didn't even say thank you. She's going back to her family, maybe. Her mom and dad were probably very scared. Or her wolf husband.
Maybe her wife. We don't know.
You three back to the settlement before your parents think you were eaten by wolves.
Oh, all right.
Chin up, Canute. You were very brave today. All of you. In future, you should not be exploring the woods alone, you understand?
But you go off on your own all the time.
Because I am very wise, and you have a lot to learn.
Yes, but there are three of us. That balances everything.
That is not quite how it works. Stand back! Are you all right?
Thanks to our hero, this dog wolf. DeWolfka.
What?
DeWolfka. It's like dog wolf.
No, I don't like that at all. We should name her Mouse.
That makes no sense. I think we should call her Chewy, because she chews things. What do you think, Eivor?
They all suck, but this one's alright.
Chewy, I suppose. Good as any other.
She's our best friend.
Now we need to get home. All five of us.
Fine.
We only wanted to have an adventure like you, Eivor. And we did! And we got a new friend!
Part of adventuring is learning a good lesson. Did you know that?
Yes, the boring part.
Well, have you children learned anything about wild animals today?
Maybe.
Yes, befriend them at any cost.
They are perfect companions and very kind. My mother always told me to avoid wild animals. Shows what she knows.
How about we think quietly on what we have learned? Just until we get home? I think she's quite fond of you.
I know she is. We saved her.
She'd be rotting away by now. Just like that boar you killed, Eivor.
You saw that?
We see everything.
Let's not tell your parents, all right? Now scamper off home. And take your new friend with you.
Salutations!
Have you got a contract for me?
Another day, another series of tasks that require a keen eye and a talent for violence. Interested? There will be contracts when...
I will see you later, friend.
You go on, I'll still be here.
Those invaders never stood a chance. Not when you are armed with Gunnar's handiwork.
What have you got for me today?
Ready for battle.
Can you remind me what you do here?
If you need weapons and armor enhanced or adorned, that's what I'm here for.
I must take my leave. So long.
Fight.
I would like to see what you have in stock.
Only a fool would pass this up. I'll be sure to keep these in stock for you. You should buy that. Eivor, you should definitely get this. It looks made for you. Did this with you in mind. This was made for you. Made from only the finest materials. Always a pleasure doing business, Eivor. Done shopping for the day?
I have to go. See you soon.
Don't be a stranger!
Right. Bring out my lieutenant. All right. I would like to reorganize the crew.
Good for now?
I'm off. Be well, friend.
Forum.
actually a very good idea.
You look well.
Eivor, good day.
I want to see the Alliance map. Those Dane invaders, they came from East Anglia, is that right?
Yes. Dane invaders who serve a man called Ruard. He seems to be sowing discord among Saxons and friendly Danes alike. Years ago, the sons of Ragnar hoped to pacify the land. They appointed a steward named Finnir to find a suitable Saxon king. But the kingdom has fallen into ruin since, with no king and violent raiders ravaging what little peace remains. I suggest you make for East Anglia and find out what their steward is doing wrong.
We'll make the trip east, then. Speak to this Finnir myself.
A good plan.
Safe travels.
I need your eyes, my friend.
To the waves!
You salt skulls. Got a story?
Enough to say!
can drive, Troll Shagger!
Have a look, Sunan.
Drunken fool, McAlbum!
You tend to your sheep, to your cattle, and look away from the knaves that creep ever closer.
When you see him dead, he's not sick with a ton of
Norwich, suffering hard times, I see. Survey the area, Sunan.
As you would expect, I have contracts that need doing. Again. We're always looking for help, so come back anytime.
Well, if it isn't Eivor of the Raven Clan.
How do you know me?
People talk. I've heard all the rumors that Eivor the Dane is a coward, a cur, and a leech. Perhaps you can swing that wee axe on your belt, but I doubt you've much talent for speech.
You might be surprised. Let us duel.
Well, I'll need a wager first.
Here's the silver. Now begin.
To all those whom I speak, they say Eivor's a clod.
Then you're speaking to fools and their knowledge is flawed.
Well, not bad. They say you're a coward who runs from a fight.
And they are sorely mistaken. I'm known for my might.
Interesting. Silent whispers all claim that you're terribly dense.
And you have clearly misheard them. My wit is immense.
Oh, you lucked out with that one. Well, what a surprise. Eivor of the Raven Clan is a true talent. I'm shocked.
Do not believe everything you hear. Unless it touches on my flighting, then heed every word.
Take the coin, and know that only praise will henceforth cross my lips.
Exquisite fletchings. Fitting feathers for a kingslaying. Touch not that throne! It was blessed by a priest, as were the arrows. These arrows are very lovely. Very lovely indeed.
The pagans ordered King Edmund to renounce God and all that is holy, but even being bound and bludgeoned, our lord held fast to his faith. Our monarch bid them do their worst, for he would not bend to their will. With their cruel barbs, the heathens martyred him in this place. Damn. Yeah. Loud. An estate in the woods, a wandering monk spread rumors of a Roman ruin southeast of Norway. Duty compels me to search such a site, but there are darker things in these lands than rogue Danes, or so the monk says. For now I shall quell my quickening heart. The ruins have survived many winters. They may wait longer. I must stay alive long enough to explore them. Cool. Well, you're incredibly loud, so I might as... that later. Okay.